tell you how to do this and how to do that. That's what he's talking about in that scripture. It's all dealing with kingdom. It's all dealing with kingdom. He will give you insight that the heathen doesn't have. Because they have not yielded their subconscious mind to thought. Insight. That's what he was talking about over here in Genesis 28. He wants you to be fruitful, to multiply, to replenish, and to subdue. Subdue means to just dominate. To dominate or control. You dominate that area of gifting that God has given you in the kingdom. Your area of gifting is being a clerk in the store. And every time they come in that store, they can't come in there and say, well, it's such a sense why she ain't working today. She should be here every day this time. Come back to work the next day. Such came here. All these people come here and ask her why you wasn't here. They just look for you. They not look for you. They look for the gift. You have demonstrated something that they lack. You ain't know. I tell people all the time. I tell people the guys that come down and say, we all are replaceable. You never get so arrogant to think that you're not replaceable.
That's right.
You say, well, they need us. No, they don't need you. This company was in existence 30 years before Raphael, they knew Raphael already. They might be in existence 30 more years after Raphael or gone. You never get into a place of arrogance to think that they need you. Kingdom is that you think like your father. You deal with things as your father. It's all kingdom. It's all kingdom. Next week we're going to start dealing with colonization, other aspects of the kingdom calling. We're going to deal with colonization and all of these other things. We're going to walk ourselves up to be dedicated kingdom citizens. It's important that you keep notes because you're going to be able to use these notes to teach. Amen. Don't just come in here and say you come in here to hear me teach. You come in here to be discipled. You come in here to be discipled. A disciple is one that follows that which you is called. Jesus had disciples. But also John the Baptist had disciples. Disciple is just one that follows that which they taught. Jesus taught the kingdom. We've got a lot of people here saying they're disciples of Jesus, but they know nothing about what he taught. Follow what he's taught. Now again, I say, the objective of this class, the objective of me coming here, is that one day I can come back here and sit down and listen to you all teach. Is that the objective? That's the objective. There's no big eyes and little U's in the kingdom.
anybody can identify that. That's what me and my wife is.
Yes, sir.
That night, that night, I told my wife, I said, you're on fire.
Amen.
And I'm gonna try to help you as much as I can, but I'm thirsty too. So she's on fire, and there's no better place, and I said, we're gonna start the new year off right.
Yeah.
Hungry and thirsty, not hungry.